Hello, Russell. How goes it?
So the first time I met you was sixth grade, my first middle school youth group. I had no idea who you were. I was just extremely nervous about coming into a new youth group, new setting, because my closest friend from Kid Fusion had just moved away and gone to a new church. So I felt like I knew nobody there, and then you're just standing at the door greeting everyone, every new sixth grader. And it's just like that one moment just made me feel right at ease with going to middle school and just,
you know. I only remember that somebody mentioned that you were part of NIAC, because at that time I was going to NIAC. They're like, hey, do you know Russ? Like, he also went to NIAC. I'm like, that's cool. I don't know who you are.
I think I met you, Russ, in middle school, but middle school was kind of a blur to me. And I don't really remember the first time I met you, therefore it was definitely during middle school.
I met you the day before I was going into my first day of sixth grade. You had preached a sermon at like big church, and just kind of like not so subtly plugged middle school youth group. And I was like, oh, I'm in middle school. I'll go do that. So I came in and I was, you know, struggling with a lot of things. And I came in and I just like immediately felt the love you had for not only the Lord, but your love for all of the kids that you interacted with.
I met you as a senior in high school, and then I met you again more officially as the guy who was interviewing me to be your assistant.
So during that summer, I was hanging out with Levi a ton, and yeah, we would play. We would like go out to the driving range every day, and so that happened to be when Pastor Jason was leaving and Pastor Russ came on. So, yeah. No, but that was the first. I think this was literally the first activity that Russ did with a student, was that he went with myself and Aaron Raley and Levi and played golf at Arrowhead in Milton, and it was like we all played terrible. None of us could play golf. And none of us can play golf now, so.
I am always amazed by how engaging you are with the students and how thoughtful you are. I don't think that people give you enough credit for how thoughtful of a person you are.
I think your biggest impact on me is probably just like reminding me to always be myself. Like I've said, that's something I've struggled with for a long time, and just seeing you every week, just always being yourself, not trying to in any way hide who you are, just being that way, and you being yourself just remind me to always be myself, never change that.
Well, apart from nurturing me back to health during the first day of life, like a baby bird, your kindness and compassion has really resonated with me since the end of life, and your wisdom has always been a big factor in my life since then.
The biggest impact you had on me, Russ, I mean, you just were a great friend to both me and my whole family. You really did a lot to grow both me and my brothers in the church, and my whole family loved taking care of you and your kids on days off when you would go out, give you some time to go out and hang out with Bree and connect with Kiki, Eli, and Owen. Always great times.
The greatest impact you've had on me is giving me a love for ministry. You have opened up doors for me to get into ministry, and it's given me a love for that, such as allowing me to be one of your middle school leaders. Gave me the experience with this one student who really like showed me that God's calling for me was in youth ministry.
Is probably the fact that I grew up doing ministry alongside you, so we've kind of like built the culture together with our leaders and the students, and you taught me how to love them by their name, using their name. You taught me how to love them by just being present. And that's like ministry impact. Personally, you have just been really incredible. You've called me out when I've needed that, which has helped me grow. And you have taught me how to be able to express when I am needing help, which is usually pretty hard for me. I'm trying to think of a really funny story that's appropriate.
How to engage with people who are significantly different than, like, in age than you, because it's hard, especially for someone who's past 30, it's hard to connect with high schoolers where, like, I don't know, you can come off as seeming really old with the things that you say sometimes, right? So how to connect with the youth?
Past 6 years, I just have too many stories to tell. I just remember, I think specifically at Life 2019, after we were in a room together, all the students sharing like really intense, hard things, and we were all supporting each other. And you came up to me after and you hugged me, which we had never hugged before, so it was really weird, but it was like a side hug, and I was like, why are you hugging me? It's a little odd. And you just expressed to me that we had been doing ministry together, and this is why we did it. We did it for them, and that we were able to do it together. And that was just like, was awesome. It just kind of solidified why we're in ministry together. So
you always have a great way of making people laugh and just making people feel at ease. And that's just something that's going to be missed, but something that I hope to strive for too.
You should definitely put like in the arms of an angel.
Yeah, so a great memory that I have of you is when you woke me up in my bedroom and scared the poop out of me. yeah, I will never forget that.
Wow. Well, I'm really going to miss a lot of the stuff we've done together, or did together, such as like car rides home, where you've picked me up after like a parent has been very disrespectful towards me and made me not want to be a leader or like hurt my self-confidence, or our science experiments, like tacos and let's see, ice cream, Panera. Oh dude, I love food. I'm gonna miss getting food with you, dude.
Yeah, probably my favorite story is just how we created Russ University, because I'm the random homeschool kid from middle school youth group.
Bird shirts.
Yeah, that's way too hard. Yeah, finding an appropriate memory of Russ is way too difficult. Nobody will admit it, but we'll all miss your random, unrelated poop stories during staff meetings.
And also, it's one car ride when you asked me, how do you stay positive as a leader and a good role model when people are disrespecting you? And I couldn't come up with an answer. All I could do was say, like, yeah, I laugh it off. Like, I just pretend it's not happening. And one, you like kind of subtly hinted that's not a good answer and I should like probably deal with that. And also, you didn't give me an answer. You let me figure it out on my own. And I think that was a very big step in me as a leader and trying to figure out what leadership means to me.
There's so many things. Side note, you can't drive. You suck at driving. We had a rental car in Atlanta and he almost killed four of us.
When super people coming out. There's nobody better for the job. I had relationships with all the pastors coming up, but there's no one I stayed connected to like I stayed connected to Russ.
Yeah, unless you have anything. That seems pretty good.
No, that's it. See you later.
Yeah, come on. Stalk your fiance.
My favorite memory of you is when you came into my bedroom.
He like drugged himself.
I took a few too many.
No, no, we don't talk about that. Oh my gosh, Dramamine and laxatives. No, like, no, but she doesn't know about that. She doesn't know about that. Now she's gonna make fun of me about that.
If you could ask one question.
After I took, no, 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 no.
Yeah,
no, that's no, 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 no. That was a Dramamine, because I took way too much Dramamine. When I got to life on like the second day, because.
Movie one is that movie one work, bro.
What's happening? Am I that short?
Movie one.
Okay.
I just love how that sentence started with like. You really taught me how to, you know, interact with people who are really different.
Yeah, that was like, yeah.